You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
As the battle between the newly evolved Hakaishin mode Vegeta versus Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku now continues on Beerus's planet, Beerus and Whis continue to observe the overall battle involving Goku and Vegeta to see which one of them is in fact the strongest, as seen on the previous manga chapter video, with both Goku and Vegeta having to acknowledge one's strength in battling for superiority and finding out which one of the two and taking the paths of the Angel and God of Destruction is now the strongest. The score will in fact be settled here, but the question going forward is, will Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku be able to get the better of Hakaishin Vegeta, or will Vegeta prove that by taking the path of learning from a God of Destruction will prove to be more effective than having to learn from an Angel? Now, before we dive any further into this video, if you are new to the channel and of course have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime related, and want to be kept up to date with everything in regards to Dragon Ball, the Dragon Ball Super manga, and everything involving the Dragon Ball IP, then I do encourage you guys to go on over and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single video on this channel, as well as giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply stoked, ready, and excited to see what the future holds in regards to the Dragon Ball franchise. And with all that being said, I want to thank you all so much for your support, and let's dive straight into the video. As our story continues with a massive beam struggle having to be shown occurring in the distance, with both Beerus and Whis having to observe, as of course Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku's Kamehameha is pushing against Hakaishin and Vegeta's final flash, and with Beerus and Whis having to oversee this, Beerus went on to comment, "Just look at them go, Whis. I have no doubt that Vegeta will overpower Goku and defeat him by the very end. The nature of destructive power is not something for anyone to take lightly, even if they bear angelic techniques." As Whis went on to respond, "I wouldn't be so sure of that, my lord. Although Vegeta has shown tremendous amounts of improvement since training with you, there is a reason why Ultra Instinct is incredibly difficult to master, even for destroyers." As Beerus went on to ask, "And what? What exactly are you trying to suggest here, Whis? The power of absolute destruction, once mastered, cannot be beaten. Do you disagree?" As Whis then went on to respond, "But then why are such beings who are also gods of destruction finding it very difficult to master Ultra Instinct, but Goku did not? The weapon of destruction causes one to lose sight of the battle and only focus on ending things on a destructive note. The difference is Goku has full control, whereas Vegeta does not. Surely Vegeta's destructive energy is hurting Goku, but there is nothing that Vegeta could do to counter the counter that Goku has as a response to him. It's the perfect counter to a counter. Goku mastered Ultra Instinct not because he could, but because he knew he couldn't, and did everything he could to learn more about it that allowed him to break through. But we shall see how each fighter responds to the other in battle. I have no doubt that this will be over very soon." As Beerus went on to smirk by responding, "So you think because Goku was able to achieve something the gods were not, that it places him above what we are at our peak? Interesting. But we will see. Vegeta won't fail. Not yet." But it was only at that moment where a massive explosion is then seen, as Whis went on to chime in, "My, my, look at the impact of that explosion. The energy waves they were emitting could no longer be sustained by the force in which they were using to attack with." As Beerus went on to ask, "What happened? I can't see anything down there. Did one of them fall?" As Whis responds, "No, I don't think so, my lord. However, I think they're both looking to finally settle things to see who is superior." As Beerus went on to respond, "Damn that Goku. He can't be that difficult to destroy. Vegeta needs to use everything and find any method he can to put Goku down. But then, As soon as Vegeta is shown then having to charge right through the smoke, Vegeta knew exactly what was going on as he then went on to shout, "Oh no you don't, Kakarot! You're not out of the woods against me just yet!" And as Vegeta went on the attack, Goku went on to dodge each and every single one of Vegeta's punches as he went on to then tell him, "I'm amazed at how powerful you've become, Vegeta. Each one of your strikes is getting heavier and heavier, but it's going to take more than power to destroy what I am. There has to be a limit to this power of yours, and I'm going to do everything in my power to find and exploit it." And with Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku then shown having to connect a thunderous knee strike to Vegeta's stomach, Goku then went on to tell him, "Face it, Vegeta, you can't beat me. My power comes from an angelic place where my body and mind are one. The only thing this power of yours is good for is to destroy. That's it. Not to evolve oneself, but to simply destroy. There's a difference in our power," and right before Goku can follow through, by hammer striking Vegeta across the head, Vegeta went on to completely vanish as he went on to acknowledge Goku by telling him, "There's more to my power than what you see on the surface, Kakarot." I will say this though, Whis says, Vegeta is quite resilient despite Goku landing such a heavy blow. And with Goku shown trying to pay attention to his surroundings in figuring out where Vegeta was, he then went on to comment, "Alright, where are you, Vegeta? I can sense you around here somewhere. You're moving at insane speeds to avoid me detecting you." The Hokai, Goku says. Where did that just come from? Because from Goku's right hand side, we get to see how in fact there was a massive Hokai ball having to be shown flying towards his direction, which at the same time, there was yet another Hokai blast shown coming from his left side as Goku went on to respond, "And another one. Now I see what you're trying to do. You were trying to ambush me between these attacks." And with Goku being quick enough in having to avoid this blast from having to sandwich him in, that's when Whis went on to comment, "Goku's fighting senses continue to improve. If he had wasted another second, those attacks really would have done a number on him. Vegeta's strategy nearly paid off, but Goku was simply too fast for Vegeta's attacks to make contact against him. Goku looks as though he has the edge in this battle. Wouldn't you agree, Lord Beerus?" As Beerus went on to respond, "Vegeta is far from finished with him, Whis. As a matter of fact, I think Vegeta has much more in store for Goku than he's letting off. I have no doubt that he will be the winner of this duel in the end." And with Vegeta shown having to cleverly enough sneak up behind Goku in punching Goku directly in the spine, Vegeta then went on to comment, "You won't be able to avoid me forever. And whenever there's a chance for me to hurt you, I'm going to take it. This is the embodiment of all the years I had to take a backseat to your power. That gap closes here." And with Goku then having to be shown hitting the ground below, that's when Beerus went on to ask, "What did I tell you, Whis? Destructive power isn't something to frown on." And as Vegeta is then shown making his way towards Goku, that's when Whis went on to respond, "Goku has prepared for this very thing, my lord. He's trained his body to not only endure the toll angelic techniques and power has on the body, but to also endure the punishment of his enemies while using that power as well. Such was the difference between Moro and Goku on Earth." And with Vegeta shown having to descend on down in punching the ground beneath him and Goku having to avoid this by vanishing, that's when Beerus went on to respond, "Even so, destructive power can be used so as long as the user has the heart to endure, which Vegeta does. He's not known for quitting despite the difference between him and his opponent. He continues to grow despite the odds stacked against him." And with Goku then shown having to reappear and kicking Vegeta directly in the face, that's when Goku went on to tell him, "I'm simply too fast for you to catch on, Vegeta." And as Vegeta's body is then shown flying off into the distance, that's when Whis went on to respond, "I have no doubt that Vegeta was made for this. This power suits him much better than Ultra Instinct considering his nature, but Goku has had time to perfect this power whereas Vegeta has not. In order for Vegeta to use this power to its full extent, he needs more time to learn about it and use it. I have no doubt that he's currently learning more about it, but Goku has had more time to train and use Ultra Instinct better. I'm not surprised that Vegeta has endured this much, however, he's doing much better than Moro did when he was met by Goku's attacks. This goes to show the will and strength Vegeta has to keep on pushing and evolving. But it's hard to say if he will best Goku, especially since Goku has had more time to use Ultra Instinct. I still stand by Vegeta to win this, Whis," says Beerus. "We will see which path is more beneficial, the path of the angels or the path of the destroyers. I will admit watching them fight is giving me the bug to jump in," as Whis went on to respond, Even so, Vegeta does have wonderful counters as a response for Goku's efforts, but I do not believe that this will stop Goku but only slow him down as such. Does this mean you will fight now too? As Goku went on to punch Vegeta with Vegeta having to catch Goku's punch, that's when Vegeta went on to tell Goku, "Face it, Kakarot, your power is useless if you don't have the will to use it to destroy. Lord Beerus has awoken my true potential, one that will allow for me to finish what you can't, which you've been known for doing. Just like how you get stronger with Ultra Instinct, I too continue to get stronger while using this Hakaishin power." And with Goku then having to quickly back away, that's when he went on to comment, "Damn it, my hand, I feel as though I'm catching fire each time I touch you." And with Vegeta trying to do exactly that by having to touch Goku and attacking him, that's when Vegeta went on to tell Goku, "Even if by some chance you had the power to destroy me, Kakarot, you still lack the will to get it done." But that's when Goku went on to retaliate by punching Vegeta in the face by telling him, "If I wanted to destroy Vegeta, I could already have done it, but it's not who I am. It's not the way I choose to evolve myself. And yes, I do lack the spirit to just destroy without consideration, but it doesn't mean that I can't if I had to. I've trained myself to use this power in ways that go beyond just destroying. However, if I had to, then I will. You can't beat me." As Goku went on to uppercut Vegeta in the face, Vegeta quickly went on to counter by attempting to punch Goku by telling him, "I'll be the judge of that, you clown. Try not to let this power of yours go to your head," as they only then get into a test of strength. As of course the two are shown having to struggle, that's when Goku went on to respond, "Oh, you're one to talk, Vegeta. Just like you, I won't stop evolving no matter what it is. You've been right there, neck and neck with me ever since, so I'll give you that much, but dream on if you think you'll surpass this level of power, not while I can continue to evolve it." As Vegeta went on to respond, "Evolve it as much as you'd like, you won't be able to get past what I will become. Look at you, you're struggling, what's the matter? Not winning as easily as you thought? You're losing ground, Kakarot, either give up now and admit defeat, or I'll knock you out just like I did before." But Goku wasn't having it as he went on to punch Vegeta in the face by telling him, "No you won't, not this time." And with Goku shown having to punch Vegeta back as Vegeta went on to maintain his balance after having to crash through the landscape, that's when Vegeta went on to say to himself, "Stupid Ultra Instinct, if he thinks I'm done for, then he has another thing coming. At some point, he will burn himself out, and when he does, I'll..." But then, that's when Vegeta stops, because he then noticed how Goku was standing right in front of him, and as he did, Goku went on to wind his fist back and telling Vegeta, "It's over, Vegeta." And what Goku tried to do was he went on to wind his fist back in nearly making contact with Vegeta, but then Goku's fist literally stopped inches away from Vegeta's face because it looks as though Goku was in fact trying to end the fight right then and there, but then something had managed to garner Goku's attention in preventing him from doing so, because from there, we only then get to see how Vegeta's hand was shown having to be placed right on Goku's chest that basically went on to indicate that even if Goku was looking to knock Vegeta's head off, Vegeta's hand placement was right there in position ready to also end Goku, which basically caused this battle to end in a stalemate, as Vegeta then went on to tell Goku, "One Hakai is all it would have taken, Kakarot." And with Goku left absolutely baffled, he then went on to ask, "When did you..." "Now I see, Vegeta," as Vegeta went on to respond, "If that was going to be what ended my life, then this was going to be yours." "Ha," Goku says. "Well played, Vegeta. So I guess we're even then." "Yeah. For now, Kakarot. For now." And with Goku and Vegeta shown separating, that's when Goku went on to respond, "I wasn't expecting for you to react so quickly. To be honest, I don't think I would have been able to escape that, Vegeta." "Well, if you were going to knock my head off," says Vegeta, "at least I wouldn't die without taking you with me. It's only fair." And with Whis and Beerus having to be shown applauding the two, that's when Whis went on to respond, "Bravo, you two, that was truly phenomenal. Both of you have grown beyond our expectations. And within such a short time, too. Well done. Truly remarkable," as Beerus went on to respond, "Yes, that was in fact a godly battle indeed. My hat's off to you both for your display." "So what was that you were saying earlier, my lord?" says Whis. "That Ultra Instinct wasn't as durable or as strong as a destroyer's destructive power? Well look, Goku's still in one piece, isn't he?" And with Beerus having to be shown aggravated, he then went on to respond, "Don't get ahead of yourself, Whis. Goku's not unbeatable because he was just nearly beaten." And with Whis having to redirect his focus at Goku, he then went on to acknowledge Goku by telling him, "I've noticed some openings in your ability to use the master variation of Ultra Instinct, which means you still have much to learn as you continue to evolve this power. Although you are nearing the angels in strength, you still pale in comparison to what we can truly do. So let's continue our training some more. Although you are beginning to have greater command over Ultra Instinct, there is still much for you to know before you are able to use it naturally like us angels. Come now, I want you to use this power against me. If you manage to land a single scratch on me, then I will reveal more to Ultra Instinct than you know. Come then, we'll train on the other side of this planet, and with Beerus shown having to also crack his knuckles, Beerus went on to further address Vegeta by telling him, "As for you, Vegeta, knuckle up, because since you are able to use a destroyer's power, I want to see how you stack up against me. And for the record, I won't be going easy on you like I have before, either. Now you'll get to see, little by little, what I am truly capable of. Are you ready, Saiyan?" And with Vegeta shown clenching his fist, he then went on to respond, "If it means surpassing both you and Kakarot, then let's do it. I will continue to get stronger until all limits to my power are shattered and there's nothing left for me to achieve. A bottomless power that cannot be matched by any mortal or god. Let's do this, Lord Beerus." As only then, the Beyond Dragon Ball Super Special story of Hakaishin Vegeta vs. Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku fan manga finale then comes to a close. Now, what I really enjoyed when putting this story together was having the overall narrative be included of two students, Goku and Vegeta, having to follow two separate paths in discovering two different kinds of powers, one path having to take one down the path of the angels while the other had led you down the path of the destroyers, and having Goku and Vegeta kind of meet and once again cross those paths and seeing which one of them is in fact superior. Granted, the ending of their confrontation can be looked at as either Goku having to win or Vegeta having to win, because either way, despite one having to make the fatal move over the other, if Goku had gone about punching Vegeta's head off, then Vegeta would have Hokai'd Goku from existence, and if it was Vegeta who had went off to Hokai Goku, then Goku would have had enough time in punching Vegeta's head off. So in the comment section below, what I want to know from you guys is, who do you interpret as being the winner of this battle? And more importantly, who do you think was right by the end of this? Was it in fact Beerus or was it in fact Whis? So I really hope you guys enjoyed this story. If you guys did, then be sure to go on ahead and give this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below. It does help out the video and the channel a lot. And if of course you guys just so happen to be new to the channel and love Dragon Ball and anime, then be sure to smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single video posted onto the channel. And if you guys believe that I should continue this series in kind of doing like somewhat of a spin-off by having MUI Goku versus Whis and also showcasing Hakaishin Vegeta versus Beerus, then be sure to let me know down in the comment section below. Again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. Tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network. Which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life in taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so very much for your support, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck's up, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes! Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Frieza.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm Unrelent Gaming! But once you get video, I'll lots of likes! Or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Vados, get over here! Tell them
these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Ant Gaming fan. This is my moment. I'm a part of his notification squad. Universe 7 can have all the fun. I just want the food.
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video. Show some love for the best community on YouTube.
Kakarota!